Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. Today we are going to discuss Basel convention which is related to control of transboundary hazardous movement of hazardous waste. In today's world, the developed as well as the developing nations are very much concerned about the stopping or controlling of the transboundary movement of the hazardous waste. Why there is a need to control this waste is that if it is left uncontrolled and significant steps are not taken for the same, it may take heavy toll of life. In order to minimize the movement of hazardous waste and their disposal, the Basel Convention on the Control of Transboundary Movement of Hazardous Waste and their Disposal was adopted. The learning outcomes of this chapter will be of this module will be in-depth understanding of the Basel Convention and analysis of the provisions of the Basel Convention and its importance and impact in today's world. With the advancement of technology, the industries and their increased usage has affected the environment, impacting the natural resources. Awakening environmental awareness and corresponding tightening of environmental regulations in the industrialized world in the 1970s and 80s led to increasing public resistance to the disposal of hazardous waste in accordance with what became to be known as the NIMBY, that is NIMBY, which basically means not in my backyard syndrome, and to an escalation of disposal cost. It was against this background that the Basel Convention was negotiated in the late 1980s. Its thrust at that time of its adoption was to combat the toxic trade, as it was termed. India ratified the convention on 24th June 1992, and it came into force in India on 22nd September 1992. The Basel Convention has 170 member countries, and it aims to protect human health and the environment against the adverse effects resulting from the generation, management, transboundary movements, and disposal of hazardous and other waste. The Conference of the Parties, which is commonly known as COP, of which all the states that are party to the convention are members, develops the policy that will guide and help in the implementation of the convention. And it can adopt amendments to the convention as well as new instruments such as protocols. The Conference of the Parties had played a very important role in making the Basel Convention functional. The COP meets at least once every 2 years and seeks to reach its decision by consensus. The aims and objectives of the Basel Conventions. The first aim of the Basel Convention is to protect human health and environment against adverse effects of hazardous waste. The next aim is to the reduction of hazardous waste generation and the promotion of environmentally sound management of hazardous waste wherever with the place of disposable. The reduction of hazardous waste generation and the promotion of environmentally sound management of hazardous waste wherever is the place of disposal. Helping developing countries with the environmentally sound management of the hazardous and other waste that they generate. The restrictions of transboundary movement of hazardous waste, except where it is perceived to be in accordance with the principles of environmentally sound management. A regulatory system applying to cases where transboundary movements are permissible. The historical backdrop or how the Basel Convention came into being is very interesting. The management of hazardous waste was included as one of the three priority areas in United Nations Environment Policy's first Montevideo program in 1981. The Basel negotiation process started in 1987 and continued till 1989. The Cairo guidelines were approved by the governing councils of United Nations Environmental Programme in June 1987 to assist governments in development and implementation of their national policies on hazardous waste. The ad hoc working group of legal and technical experts with a mandate to prepare a global convention on the control of transboundary movements of hazardous waste began its deliberations at an organizational meeting in October 1987 and held a total of 5 negotiations. The 5 sessions between February 1988 and March 1989 under the orders from the Governing Council of UNEP were held. There was a conference of plenipotentiaries. The conference of plenipotentiaries on the Global Convention on the control of transboundary movement of hazardous waste, convened at the invitation of the Swiss government from 20 to 22nd March 1989 in Basel, in which 116 states were represented, considered the final draft of the convention submitted to it by the working group. The Basel Convention was thus adopted by the Conference of the Plenipotentiaries on 22nd March 1989. 105 states and the European Economic Community, that is the EEC, signed the final act of the Basel Conference. On 22nd March 1990, when the Basel Convention was closed for signature, in accordance with Article 21, 53 states and the EEC had signed it. Scope of the convention. Under Article 1, the scope of the convention has been laid down as: hazardous waste are those wastes that belong to any category in Annexure 1 unless they do not possess the characteristics as mentioned in Annexure 2 of the Basel Convention. Waste that are not covered under the above provision but are defined or as or considered to be hazardous waste by the domestic legislation of the party of export, import or transit. Other waste that are contained in Annexure 2. So Article 1 of the convention makes it very clear that on all what all waste the Basel Convention will be applicable. The general obligations of the parties are very clearly laid down or outlined in Article 4 of the Basel Convention. It says that the party shall prohibit the export and import of hazardous waste and other waste and will inform the other parties of their decision. Each party shall take measures to ensure the generation of hazardous and other waste is reduced to the minimum, ensure the availability of adequate disposal facility, ensure that the persons involved in the management of hazardous waste and other waste take steps to prevent pollution, to ensure the reduction of transboundary movement of hazardous waste and other waste, and cooperate in activities with other parties and interested organization on the issue of transboundary movement of hazardous and other waste and their disposal. It also lays in the general obligations that each party to consider illegal traffic in hazardous waste as criminal. Under Article 6, transboundary movement between boundaries has been laid down. It states that the state of export shall notify the competent authority of the state any proposed transboundary movement of hazardous waste. The state of import shall inform and notify in writing, consenting or denying the permission. No such movement will commence till the notify has received a written consent and a confirmation of the existing contract. Under Article 9, illegal traffic has been dealt. It says that, or it states that, illegal traffic is any transboundary movement of hazardous waste without notification pursuant to provisions of this convention to all the states or a particular state concerned if consent obtained through falsification, misrepresentation or fraud or such movement that results in deliberate disposal of hazardous waste will be termed as illegal traffic. International cooperation has been laid down in Article 10 of the Basel Convention, which says that international cooperation means to cooperate with each other in order to improve and achieve environmentally sound management of hazardous and other waste. parties to make available information on bilateral and multilateral basis, cooperating the efforts of management of hazardous waste on human health and environment, to regulate policies in the implementation and development of environmentally sound technologies, to develop technological sound guidelines, encourage to promote public awareness and sound hazardous management system. The Conference of Parties has been outlined or elaborated under Article 15, which states that Conference of Parties is established having its first meeting in 1 year after its formation and thereafter ordinary meetings at regular intervals. It shall by consensus agree upon the rules of procedure. It shall keep under continuous review, evaluation, effective implementation of the convention, promote harmonization of policies, consider and adopt amendments in the convention, consider and undertake any additional action required for the achievement of the purpose of the convention. It further says that it shall undertake 3 years after the entry into force of this convention and at least 6 years thereafter an evaluation of its effectiveness and, if necessary, the imposition of complete or partial ban on transboundary movement of hazardous material. The general consideration on environmentally sound management has been very effectively dealt with in the Basel Convention. But to understand what is environmentally sound, first we need to understand what is environmentally sound management. The environmentally sound management is a broad policy concept without a clear universal definition at the current time. However, provisions pertaining to ESM, that is environmentally sound management, as it applies to hazardous waste within the Basel and Stockholm Conventions and also the Organizations for Economic Cooperation and Development, that is OECD, core performance elements provide international direction that is also supportive of ESM efforts underway in various countries and among industrial sector. So, summarizing, it means that all the countries should follow environmentally sound management of the of dealing with the hazardous material in order to become cooperate, in order to have cooperation amongst each other for disposal of the waste and other waste. The provision on ESM under the Basel Convention. The Basel Convention in paragraph 8 of Article 2 defines ESM of hazardous waste or other waste as taking all practicable steps to ensure that hazardous waste or other waste are managed in a manner which will protect human health and the environment against adverse effects which may result from such waste. In paragraph 2, subclause B of Article 4, the convention requires each party to take the appropriate measures to ensure the availability of adequate disposal facilities for the environmentally sound management of hazardous or other waste. In paragraph 2, subclause C, it requires each party to ensure that persons involved in the management of hazardous waste or other waste within it take such steps that are necessary to prevent pollution due to hazardous waste and other waste. In paragraph 8 of Article 4, the convention requires that hazardous waste or other waste to be exported are managed in an environmentally sound manner in the state of import or elsewhere. Technical guidelines for the environmentally sound management of waste subject to this convention shall be decided by the parties at their first meeting. Further, the 1999 Basel Declaration on Environmentally Sound Management at its fifth meeting called upon the parties to enhance and strengthen their efforts and cooperation to achieve ESM through prevention, minimization, recycling, recovery and disposal of hazardous and other waste and through further reduction of transboundary movement of hazardous and other waste subject to this convention. ESM has recommended a number of legal, institutional and technical conditions such as, which is also known as ESM criteria, it is a regulatory and enforcement infrastructure to ensure compliance with applicable regulations, sites or facilities are authorized and are of an adequate standards of technology and pollution control to deal with hazardous waste in the way proposed, in particular taking into account the level of technology and pollution control in the exporting country. ESM also recommends operators of sites or facilities at which hazardous waste are managed are required as appropriate to monitor the effects of those activities. It also says that appropriate action is taken in cases when monitoring gives indications that the management of hazardous waste has resulted in unacceptable releases. People involved in the management of hazardous waste are capable and adequately trained in their capacity. A very important issue to discuss here is the Blue Lady issue, which is one of the major instances of Basel Convention. It says that for over a year, or the Blue Lady issue can be explained by saying that for over a year, a ship named Blue Lady containing toxic waste has idled in a Gujarat port while legal wrangling continued over responsibility of its breakup and final disposal. That means nobody was ready to take the nobody was ready to take up that who's going to take the responsibility for its breakup and final disposal. In September 2007, the Indian Supreme Court heard overwhelming evidence and laid down following guidelines that were: the Supreme Court empowered the government to send back any contaminated ship that comes to India for breaking at Alang or any other ship breaking yard in the country. The court has ordered that the government formulate a comprehensive code and immediately incorporate these recommendations until the laws are modified and aligned with the court orders. In the Blue Lady issue, the court also said that the continuation and expansion of Alang and other ship breaking yards across the country shall be permitted, subject to the compliance of these directions by the ship breakers. The order leaves little space for the authorities to allow ship breaking, even if ship owners do not provide details of contaminations on board. The court has reiterated that India should participate in relevant international conventions with the clear mandate for decontamination of ships from hazardous substances such as asbestos, waste oil, and PCBs prior to export to India for breaking. Until further orders, the court has asked the State Pollution Control Boards, Customs Department, the National Institute of Occupational Health and Atomic Energy Regulatory Board to oversee the entire arrangement at the shipyards. Now, under the Basel Convention, the waste which are regulated are of different types, such as used oils, biomedical and healthcare waste, used lead acid batteries, polychlorinated biofuels, chemical waste, and persistent organic pollutant waste. Now, for treating of these or for dealing with these waste, how does the Basel Convention works? The Basel Convention regulates the transboundary movement of hazardous and other waste, applying the prior informed consent procedure. That is, shipments made without consent are illegal. So any shipment has to be priorly informed to the receiving state. Second, the convention obliges its party to ensure that hazardous and other waste are managed and disposed of in an environmentally sound manner, that is, in an ESM manner, following the ESM criteria. Third, to this end, parties are expected to minimize the quantities that are moved across borders to treat and dispose of waste as close as possible to their place of generation and to prevent or minimize the generation of waste at source. Lastly, strong controls have to be applied from the movement of generation of a hazardous waste to its storage, transport, treatment, reuse, recycling, recovery, and final disposal. Only by this transboundary movement of hazardous waste can be controlled and minimized. Additional measures have also been laid down in the Basel Convention, which says that there must be cooperation between countries to build up the capacity to tackle illegal traffic. United Nations regional commissions and other regional bodies or conventions and protocols should take an effective part in monitoring and preventing this. It is also important that customs officers and port authorities are adequately trained and able to take full control of the hazardous waste being moved across frontiers. Parties are to cooperate in helping developing countries minimize the generation of hazardous waste and their movement across frontiers. It also says that measures can include ensuring that adequate disposal facilities are available, that managers are able to prevent pollution, and that if pollution occurs, the consequences for human health and the environment can be kept to a minimum. The Basel Convention, if we have to sum up in a few lines, we can say that the Basel Convention has been an effective international instrument where the developed as well as the developing nations are cooperating with each other in order to bring about a sustainable development or environmentally sound management of the transboundary movement of hazardous waste. To conclude, we can say that the Basel Convention lacks effective measures for enforcement, for ensuring compliance, for sanctioning, or for assigning liabilities. However, the Convention works actively with governments and private entities in the form of partnership to minimize trade in waste. Non-state actors have played active role in moving negotiations forward. And lastly, the Convention has also invested heavily in generating awareness on the problem. So, to sum up, it is pertinent to mention here that the Basel Convention is an important piece of legislation which, though has some drawbacks, but has served a long way in minimizing, in controlling, and in bringing about cooperation in management of transboundary movement of hazardous waste. Thank you.